It's recording.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Hello and welcome to Lions TV. I am here with our owner of Teesside Lions, James Thompson. Today we're meeting with philanthropist, businessman, mayoral candidate, Andy Preston. Andy Preston, thanks very much indeed for your time today.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Really enjoying having you here. Andy, first of all, where did you hear about Teesside Lions? They've got plans to bring professional basketball to the area. What's your interest in that? Do you want to play?
I first met James about 5 years ago, maybe 6 years ago, and then kind of like we both went off each other's radar. And I think about 6 to 9 months ago, James maybe made contact again. That was the first time I heard about the Lions and this project to launch the foundation to bring professional basketball to Teesside. I love it. I was immediately captured by that. I have played a tiny bit of basketball. When I was in London, we used to play a little bit after work. There were some American guys that we worked with, so we'd go in. But they were really, it was like, we wanted to play them at football, soccer, because we were like miles better, and they wanted to play us at basketball.
So you had a compromise.
Yeah, well, right. we played basketball, and I loved it. And I really am not very good, but I love it. And I've actually got a hoop at home on the side of the garage.
So it's full time.
On the side of the garage, and I with my youngest son, often stand there and have a go. I love basketball. It's a great spectator sport.
Yeah,
I think it's amazing fun. All levels of fitness can play it, and of course, unless it's played aggressively, injuries are very few and far between. So it's a fantastic participation sport. I once saw a professional game. I was in Miami, and I went to see Miami Heat. Played the Detroit Pistons. I think the Heat won. I can't remember. It was about 15 years ago.
But I bet you remember the event.
It was amazing. Mm-hmm. And you know, when you go to a US sporting event and they stand up and sing the Star Spangled Banner, and the whole place stands up, I'm getting goosebumps now. It's so moving. And it's a spectacle, there's razzmatazz. It's just an amazing family day out. I loved it. I'll go and watch basketball. I was in New York and I was out of season. I was disappointed, but I'd love to go and watch more pro basketball in the States.
Well, hopefully.
Well, I'd like to see pro basketball. I want to see pro basketball in Middlesbrough. I would love to see that.
Fantastic. James, we could be looking at the future mayor here. It's obviously the future mayor, and he's obviously all for basketball. How important is it to have influential figures involved in sports like
Well, and I think that initially just the accolades and the support from Andy almost gives us credibility and acknowledgement of what we're trying to achieve. So to have that by itself is fantastic. The recognition of people that you're doing hopefully a good job, or that your ambitions are something that they would support. I think what we're needing to do is to raise awareness of what we're trying to do, to bring basketball to this area, to have a professional event and to have an experience that, not just the game, but the event surrounding it, that for someone like Andy that would go and watch a game, and Martin as well from Lemon Business Solutions, he had the same experience going to watch Memphis Grizzlies. Where he was just overawed by the entertainment and the event itself.
Yeah.
And people go away almost looking forward to the next game.
Yeah.
I mean, you couldn't remember the result.
That's right. But and I remember that shows the spectacle you exactly. And the atmosphere.
And yeah. That's, you know, we did this before. Last time we had National League Basketball, we did this before. We were attracting 500 people to the games at Essence Sports Academy.
Yeah.
And it was Division 4 basketball. We entered the bottom tier. Mm-hmm. But we were attracting big crowds. It shouldn't have happened.
Mm-hmm.
But they were coming to watch the event, and their education of basketball was growing over the weeks and months that followed.
Yeah.
So that's what our intention is, and we need to raise awareness of this and hopefully encourage people to come along and hopefully experience a similar situation to Andy in America.
Mm. So, Andy, obviously you're renowned for being a local businessman. You're also renowned for your charity work as well.
Right.
I mean, James, I know you've got your Role Models thing up and running, which is again a non-profit charity kind of thing, basically mentoring the youngsters. How important, Andy, do you think things like Role Models are in the local community, especially with the youngsters?
I think role models in your life, in my life, but in everyone's life, are so influential. And I think good role models can take someone who's great and make them greater. I think good role models can take someone who's awful and make them great. Mm-hmm. Bad role models will have the opposite effect.
Yeah.
And that's something we need to be aware of. And we need to try and identify the bad role models and get them out of the way somehow and ship in good role models. I personally believe that having influential people around you who set high standards, who work hard and are good fun to be around, can change businesses, change communities and change towns. And it all starts at the top. It's the role model that sets the tone.
Yeah, I think sometimes as well that in a when you engage with children at an early age, children that may be vulnerable, they may have personal circumstances, family circumstances, or even just community circumstances that are leading down the wrong path. It's vital that positive role models, whether it be basketball players from Teesside Lions, or whether it be Frankie Wales from Redcar, or whether it be other positive role models, it's vital to have them in place to engage with those children and lead them in a more positive way. I remember, I mean, I've been involved in basketball now for 22 years as a player, as a coach, as an owner. And I remember a couple of examples. One was a little girl at a school called Martin Grove Primary School. And this little girl, I think her name was Sophia. And she must have been 6 or 7 years old. Now, I've got a six-year-old son, and I know how impressionable he is. He bounces all over the place. But this little girl was the opposite. She was very, very shy, very quiet. And in one of the drills, we had a circular passing drill. And you pass the ball around, and you can, if the player drops it, they would be out, they would sit down. Obviously, you come to the last person standing there, the winner of the game. And the way I did this is I ensured this little girl would win the game, and her reward for winning the game was to spin the ball on her finger. So I spun the ball and placed it on her finger, and this little six-year-old dot kind of looked up, and this smile broke out on her face. And afterwards, I spoke to the teacher, and I said, "Oh, is Sophia quite shy?" And she said, "Well, put it this way, in 2 years, that's the first time I've seen her smile."
Right, that's nice. Yeah.
And that story has stuck with me for 20 years now.
Yeah.
And I think that's the effect that a small element of attention or time or just acknowledgement can have on a person, on an individual. And I'd like to think that she's a mom. You know, actually, I remember this now. A year later, we had another class in the school, and I saw we were doing another session, and Sophia was in that class. Helping one of another younger child there,
wow. Right?
And I just you know, it's talking 20 years ago now, but the effect that a very shy, not you know, just a very reclusive person's come out of her shell, that's led her to kind of be a more positive person around other people, hopefully helping other young shy people, and that knock-on effect.
So basically, from what both of you are saying, it's quite obvious that getting kids in sport is a lot more about. It's more than just winning games, isn't it?
Completely. Yeah.